Get your bird started, and we will do a comms check when ready.
Conduct deep interdiction airstrikes in the enemy rear areas. Deep interdiction is a mission that destroys, disrupts, diverts, or delays the enemy's surface military potential before it can be used effectively against friendly forces. Typical targets are lines of communication, supply centers, radar sites, command and control nodes, or fielded forces. Deep interdiction is either performed as part of an overall theater-wide interdiction effort or as a more local effort in response to the needs of ground combat. The tactics used to conduct a deep interdiction strike depend on a number of factors, including location of the target, enemy air defenses, available strike and tanker aircraft, munitions available, and skills and experience of the air crew. Make sure you know your safe escape maneuver before you make your attack run. Deep interdiction missions rarely exit a target area from the same direction it was entered. A good rule of thumb is to never overfly the same target area twice. The hard deck on the range, the 100 feet AGM. This is the foul line, and you will fail this PO if you go below this altitude. There are a number of no-fire zones within the range. We've placed a friendly unit with EPLRS. We'll be monitoring your location on weapons release. Releasing in a no-fire zone is a violation of the weapons release restriction and immediate termination of the PO. The no-fire zones simulate combat in an urban environment where there are strict rules of engagement regarding minimum collateral damage and weapons release headings to avoid friendly fire. Remember, this is a live fire exercise. Use caution and confirm the targets before release. Good luck. Colt 1-1, Colt 1-2, follow me when ready. I'll rejoin you at waypoint 1. Baziani departure, Colt 1-2, good jet, ready for taxi.
Colt 1-2, clear to taxi to runway 14.
Colt 1-2, rolling. Baziani departure, Colt 1-2. Request clearance for takeoff.
Colt 1-2, you are cleared for takeoff and ready. Climb 300 at QFE 28.33.
Colt 1-2, rolling. Colt 1-2, airborne! Colt 1-2, wheels up!
Pull up, pull up. Altitude, altitude.
11, request taxi to runway. Colts, 1-1, request takeoff.
Colt, 1-1, Mazzani, you are cleared for takeoff and ready. Climb 300 at QFE 28.32.
1, rolling.
Starts now. Push to the tactical training frequency. Colt 1-1. Colt 1-2. Radio check.
1. Copy.
I read you Lima Charlie. Colt 1-1. Colt 1-2. Let's talk more about deep interdiction. There are two types of deep interdiction, dynamic and deliberate. Dynamic interdiction respond to targets that require time-sensitive or immediate attention deep in the enemy rear area. An example would be a high-value target identified by an SOF team. Deliberate interdiction missions allow more time to study the target imagery and to align attack axes to optimize weapons effects. Detailed study can reduce threat exposure and allow mission planners to optimize the weapons fusing for maximum effect. Intelligence, surveillance, and reconnaissance forces support interdiction planning through the collection of detailed information. Joint force commanders use this information to plan priority targets to aid the overall joint forces effort. Interdiction operations in urban areas can be problematic and require special considerations during planning. Collateral damage in cities or towns can represent risk to the joint forces effort. Friendly fire incidents and unwanted civilian casualties could result. Air refueling has become an integrated part of Interdiction Force packaging. It may be the only way to get interdiction missions to the target area. Usually, a top-up of fuel is done prior to entering the target area, and in most cases, another AAR is required to get sufficient fuel to make it back to base. To help coordinate the deep interdiction missions with the ground forces, the battlefield map has defined battle space control measures, the FEBA, FLOT, and FSCL. The forward edge of the battle area, or FEBA, is a line that defines the limits of a series of areas in which ground combat units are deployed, excluding the areas in which the covering or screening forces are operating, designated to coordinate fire support, the positioning of forces, or the maneuver of units. The forward line of troops, or FLOT, is a line that indicates the most forward positions of friendly forces. The Fire Support Coordination Line, or FSCL, is a line that facilitates the expeditious attack of surface targets of opportunity beyond the coordinating measure. Typically, targets beyond the FSCL can be attacked without engaging terminal attack controllers for clearance. The zone between the FLOT and the FSCL is the area which friendly ground forces intend to maneuver in the near future, and which terminal attack controller clearance is required. Air interdiction strike missions can occur both short of and beyond the FSCL. A kill box is a three-dimensional area used to facilitate the integration of joint fires. The primary purpose is to allow lethal attack against surface targets without further coordination with the ground forces commander and without terminal attack control. The ROE will define what targets can be attacked within the kill box. Prior to conducting airstrikes, collateral damage needs to be assessed. Collateral damage is defined as the unintentional or incidental injury or damage to persons or objects that would not be lawful military targets in the circumstances ruling at the time. Commanders have the responsibility to attempt to minimize collateral damage to the greatest extent possible. As part of strike mission planning, mission planners will determine a collateral damage estimate, or CDE. There are five CDE levels. CDE 1, no structural damage, no casualties, and no tactical restrictions. CDE 2, no structural damage, no casualties, and weapon restrictions. CDE 3, no structural damage, no casualties, and weapon and fusing restrictions. CDE 4, no structural damage, no casualties, and weapon, fusing, and delivery heading restrictions. CDE 5, structural damage, casualties, and weapon, fusing, and delivery heading restrictions. Respect the CDE classification of your targets to ensure you are putting the correct weapon on the correct target to minimize collateral damage. Since we will be maneuvering, we will do a G-awareness test shortly after passing waypoint 2. The brevity code is G-warm. warm. Colt 1, G warm, 90 left. Go. Colt 1, G warm, 90 right. Go. Fence in.
One, copy. Fence in.
Colt 1-2. Fenced in. 5.5. Range control, Colt 1-2. Request clearance for Colt 1, flight of two A-10s, west of entry Alpha. We have two AGM-65Ds, two GBU-31s, two AIM-9s, and 2,000 rounds of 30 Mike Mike.
Colt 1-2, VTA range control. You are cleared of entry Alpha. You have the airspace from 100 to flight level 150. Weather is clear, visibility good in all quadrants. Proceed to control point Bravo for tasking. Authorized Colt 1-2, control.
Colt 1-2 confirms. 100 to flight level 150. Clear of clouds. Arc deck 100. Control point Bravo. I have control. Colt 1-2, proceed to IP Edsel and set up for your attack run. Thank you. Colt 1-1, Colt 1-2. Now hold at IP Edsel until your attack time.
Pull up! Pull up!
Call 1-2. Good hits on the target. Reattack is authorized.
Bombs away.
Colt 1-2. Good hits on the target. The target has been terminated.
Rifle.
Colt 1-2. Good hits on the target. The target has been terminated. Colt 1-1, Colt 1-2. Good job. Time to egress. Colt 1-1, Colt 1-2. To help simulate a deep interdiction mission, you will have to complete a successful AAR before landing back at base. Range Control, Colt 1-2. Request clearance northeast of Exit Alpha.
Colt 1-2, VTA Range Control, cleared for Exit Alpha.
Colt 1-2, roger. Cleared for Exit Alpha. Colt 1, fence out.
1, copy. Fence out.
Colt 1-2, fenced out. 2.6. Colt 1-1, Colt 1-2. Time to get some gas for the ride home. Contact the tanker and initiate your rendezvous.
Shell 1-1, Colt 1-1, request rejoin.
Colt 1-1, Shell 1-1, proceed to pre-contact at 17,000 at 220.
Colt 1-1, Colt 1-2, visual on the tanker.
contact.
Cleared contact.
Colt 1-1, Colt 1-2. Once you feel you have enough gas, disconnect and RTB.
Contact. You're taking fuel.
Abort rejoin.
Colt 1-1, Colt 1-2. The hard deck restriction is terminated. You are permitted to land and shut down your bird. I'll give you your rating then.
Colt 1-1, inbound.
Colt 1-1, Mazzani, fly heading 308, Fort 1-6.
Colt 1-1, Colt 1-2, saddle, holding hands.
1-1. Request landing.
Colt 1-1. Mazzani, clear to land. Runway 13.
Colt 1-1, Colt 1-2, stripped!
Altitude.
Find a suitable parking spot. Colt 1-1, Colt 1-2, shut down your bird and I'll give you your rating then.
Good news! Post-flight BDA reports good strikes on all targets. You made a successful AAR. Good job! Congratulations! You passed this PO. You received a qualified rating. Well done!